So this is now the finished 172 scale Italeri American Civil War Confederate Cavalry. In the end, the coating is a acrylic coating, not a spray. I brushed it on, and as long as I can prevent bubbles from occurring, brushing is better than spraying. Because first of all, spray is a atmospheric inhibiting thing. Not too crazy about that, especially in a small space like what I potentially am in my basement here in this studio. And of course, the effects of the spray over a long period of time can build up. And I want to avoid that, so I use the brush on. This is polycrylic from Minwax. It used to be on its own company, now it's owned by Minwax. This is a wet looking, but that is normal result, because over time it's expected that this will wear off. Now I know a lot of people take and actually hit it with another spray to reduce the effect of that wet look from being either brushed on or sprayed on. The result is it tones it down, and I don't know exactly what the spray is, but I think it's another matte acrylic or other spray. But you can see this is a pretty good result. I don't normally put so much emphasis on the beards and facial hair of some of the so-called characters, but in this case I did. And looking at these figures so intently, which is not something I normally do, because generally these are wargaming figures and they're made by the hundreds each time. But lately, as the emphasis is on the smaller game table, the idea of having emphasis on the figures is causing a little bit more interest. And so therefore, because of that, let's go ahead and see, before I wreck something, that's the danger of using hot glue. Certain things can come into contact with the hot glue gun as it's sitting around, so one must be very careful. Let me grab a clear base of the ones that we've recovered from our original mountings. This is an example that's been cleaned up a little bit. And I'm now going to take these figures off and put them on that clear base. Now, as these guys are on that popsicle stick, they should just pop off, because the size of the glue that's holding them on there, isn't that much. Yep, they just kind of pop off because it's wood. And the nodule, the node of hot glue, isn't that big. It's very small. So that's the reason why they just kind of pop right off there. Now, this is going to give you an idea of the mounting. This is not entirely quite dry yet either. I should probably have waited a little bit, but I'm impatient. I want to see what these guys look like on that clear base. So, without further ado, the figure with the sword to his right, we would like to have mounted on the right side of the stand, so that if he is on the left, his sword isn't essentially interfering with somebody who's in the middle. Now generally, even in the Napoleonic War, we mount these 2 to 3 to a stand, and we're going to follow that tradition right here. So we're going to put the guy with the sword on his right, on the right side of the base. We're going to put the guy with the sword on his left. It's ironic because I didn't really plan for this to happen this way, but it's on his left because he's swishing, sorting. I don't know. What is he doing? He's swishing, slicing with his sword. Okay, I assume he's going to bring it down. We don't really know. We torso twisted this guy, so now we really don't know where he's going to go with that sword. Okay. And so then, just like in the Napoleonic and the American Revolution squadrons, we put the flag holder in the middle. If it's a three-person stand, he's in the middle. If it's a two-person stand, he's obviously in one of the two positions. So you can see that that's pretty good, but also a three-person, a three-figure configuration is also good. And it's a little bit more attractive to have more figures, and that's what the mode of our MO these days is, kind of tidying up all these things, and that's one of our other videos. So there you go. That is the three Italeri Civil War guys that we've been working on, and got them painted. We'll put the flag on and come back. I don't know what kind of flag, though. I'll have to research that a little bit. I don't have any at the ready to go on there. I do have some flags that were used for the Pea Ridge battle, but the Confederate cavalry there was dismounted. And for Shiloh, not entirely sure what cavalry, because those are the two, essentially the two periods of focus for me in the American Civil War's Western Theater. So we will look into maybe what kind of a flag it should be. A Texas unit, maybe Alabama. We'll look into it and put the right flag on there. So there we go, nice. And then we'll mount them with the hot glue, as I say. And see what they look like. Well, you can see I didn't finish quite the strapping of that one guy. I should probably do that. I can do that with a Sharpie marker to finish him. So, all in all, not bad.